Psilocybin is a naturally occurring tryptamine alkaloid. It's the principal psychoactive component of so-called magic mushrooms, Psilocybin genus of mushrooms. About 100 species of those mushrooms have been identified, and they've been used for literally for thousands of years within some cultures for structured manners and for divinatory and religious purposes. So recently, research has been reinitiated with psilocybin as a classic hallucinogen and exploring some of its potential for therapeutic application. And this work points back to research done in the 1950s and 60s for two different kinds of indications. One was in cancer patients, primarily terminally ill, and the other was in the addictions area, primarily alcoholism. And we currently have studies in both those areas going on at Johns Hopkins. So in the cancer patients, we're investigating the effects of a single psilocybin session on the existential anxiety or depressed mood that some patients experience as a consequence of their cancer diagnosis. So as you may appreciate, any terminal diagnosis can be very psychologically disruptive. And a fairly good percentage of people confronted with such a diagnosis really end up in despair and in reduced quality of life. We bring those individuals in. They're very carefully screened prior to participation. And if they qualify for the study, then we give them an opportunity to have a guided and supported psilocybin session in our laboratory. The context is that people lay down on a couch. They have headphones and eye shades. They're asked to turn their attention in on their inner experience. They're in the presence of two guides or monitors with whom they've already developed a secure and supportive relationship. And those people are there for the 8-hour session just to provide a context of safety and support. Under these conditions, with very high probability, as we've seen in both cancer patients and other studies that we've run in healthy volunteers, the majority of people have what we call a transcendent or mystical type experience. These are experiences that have actually been well characterized in the general research literature on religion. They occur naturally, and they're transformative in that they can alter very dramatically someone's entire sense of self and attitudes towards life and meaning. The characteristics of these experiences include a sense of unity, or a sense of the interconnectedness of all people and things, a sense of sacredness, reverence, a noetic sense that there's something more true and more real about this experience in everyday waking consciousness. Positive mood often accompanies these experiences, often experienced as deep gratitude or sometimes universal love. A transcendence of time and space occurs, that time collapses into the present moment. There's no past, there's no future. It's beingness now. Finally, these experiences are said to be ineffable. People, the first thing they say about this kind of experience is, you know, I can't even put it into words. But with these kinds of experiences can come great psychological healing. There's been one recent published pilot study out of UCLA. We have this trial going at Johns Hopkins currently. NYU also has a cancer trial going. And we're really quite hopeful that very systematic application of psilocybin in this context could transform end-of-life care, not only for cancer patients, but ultimately for us all.
For the cancer patients, did they report it helping their relationship with their family, or did their families report that the person was ready to pass on, or was there any family input on that?
Yeah, so with the cancer patients, one of the really interesting outcomes is their relationship to family and their caregivers. People come through these kinds of experiences with an altered core sense of self and their beingness in the world. It gives them deep inner strength. And what's really remarkable and touching is when then that deep inner strength is communicated to their caretakers. So people can come through this kind of experience and be able to say, clear-eyed and emotionally open, you know, I'm dying and it's sad and I am upset to be leaving and leaving you, but it's also okay. And there's something beautiful about this, and there's something absolutely okay, and I want you to know that.
Right.
And when that's it actually gets to me just describing it. But when someone can say that to their loved ones, it has remarkable healing direction both ways.
I can imagine.